Dear all, greetings in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For today's Lent devotion, Christmas message, we will be talking about Joseph, the earthly father of Jesus Christ and the husband of Virgin Mary. We learn from the Gospel according to Matthew that Joseph was a carpenter by trade. When townspeople needed some carpentry done that was beyond their skills and tools, Joseph would be the one they would come to. Carpentry was Joseph's world and the world Jesus grew up in. He played in the wood shavings on the floor of his father's shop. Jesus learned from Joseph the trade of carpentry, to saw and plane, drill and smooth. Jesus saw it all. In the Gospel of Matthew chapter 1 verse 19, we begin to see the character of Joseph, the man to whom Mary was engaged. Matthew says Joseph was a righteous man. Righteous meant that he carefully observed the law and valued his own reputation. Because Joseph was righteous, he did not want to expose Mary to public disgrace, and he had in mind to divorce her quietly. We see in Joseph a gentleness and maturity. He was a man seeking to do the right thing. In Matthew 1 verse 20, we see an angel of the Lord appearing to Joseph in a dream and asking him not to be afraid to take Mary as his wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. Joseph did what was commanded to him and took Mary home as his wife. He was obedient to the Lord. Next, in verse 21, the angel instructs Joseph how to name his son. The Lord said, "You are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." Joseph is commanded to personally name the child. This is significant. It means that Joseph, in naming the child, acknowledges him as his own son and thus becomes the legal father of the child according to Semitic law. The angel Gabriel had promised Mary, "The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David." In Joseph naming the boy and therefore adopting him, David becomes Jesus' earthly ancestor. The final thing we learn about Joseph happens a few years after Jesus' birth. After the wise men came to worship Jesus and had tipped off King Herod as to the presence of a possible rival heir to the throne, we see in Matthew 2:13 an angel commanding Joseph to flee. Joseph obeyed immediately and went in the middle of the night to Egypt. It was a good thing he did to protect his son and wife. Within a short time, Herod's soldiers slaughtered all the male babies in Bethlehem. In Matthew 2:19, we see that after King Herod's death and when the threat was over, Joseph brought Mary and baby Jesus back to Nazareth, in spite of what scandal still might remain there. In Nazareth, the family now lived, and it was here Jesus was raised. What we learn from the scripture about Joseph is that God chose to father his son Jesus, a man who was devout, full of faith, obedient to God, just, merciful, and one who loved and carefully guarded both Mary and the child Jesus. Let us pray. Father, thank you for Joseph, who proved worthy of your trust to raise Jesus. Help us to be as believing, as faithful, as zealous as he was, to take on the various tasks you assigned to us. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen. We wish each one of you a blessed and joyful Christmas. Thank you and God bless.